Chalo. So let us start. I think we started with the micro environment, right? We already started with the micro environment, right? Everyone? So we started before that, we started with two things. One is known as components of environment, and another one is known as types of environment, right? So what I told you, whenever you will see the word called components of environment, what are the two things should come to your mind? What are the two things should come to your mind when we talk about the components? It is known as internal and external. Now, out of SWOT, strength, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. Which one is internal? Which one is external? Strengths and weaknesses are what? Internal. Opportunities and threats are what? External. Anybody would like to continue in the class along with me? Harshini, would you? Kirti, anybody? Yes? Okay. Okay, I'm unmuting you. You now unmute yourself, Harshini.
Yes, sir.
Harshini, how are you?
Fine, sir. How are you?
Great, I'm great. Okay, so Harshini, what was the topic we did? We did the components of environment, right? So when we
Yes,
talk
sir.
about the components of environment, what are the two things comes to our mind? One is known as internal and one is known as
External.
external. So strengths and weaknesses are internal and opportunities and threats are what? External.
External.
Now, what do you mean by strength? Strength refers to inherent capacity and inherent limitation is known as what?
Weakness.
Weakness. And favorable conditions of the markets are known as opportunity.
Opportunities.
And unfavorable conditions of the markets are known as threats. So I think we already have discussed all that thing in the previous class, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. Just wait. Somebody's trying to enter. Okay. Now, next thing. And whenever we talk about the word called types, what are the two things comes to our mind? One is
Micro
environment and one is what? Macro.
macro.
So everyone, do you remember I told you the meaning of the micro? Micro stands for
Cosmic.
and macro stands for
Special.
Pascal. Everyone, write yes if you all remember that. Okay. You all remember that? Yes. So in the cosmic, what does the C stands for?
Customer.
O stands for?
Organization.
S stands for?
Suppliers.
Supplier. M stands for?
Market.
Market. I stands for?
Intermediaries,
And C stands for?
competitors.
Competitor. So I think we have done the C first. That is called customer.
Customer.
Not wrong, we have done with the C, right?
Yes,
So just repeat for everyone again. What do you mean by micro environment? Repeat. Point number one.
microenvironment is external.
Micro environment is an, it is an
It is an environment which internal but external to the organization with which business or entity interacts on daily basis.
Do we all know that micro environment is an environment which is internal? Sir, internal from whose point of view? Macro's point of view. External from the business point of view. So it is external to the business, but as compared to macro, it is external or internal?
Internal.
Internal. Right. Read that point number two.
It is also known as closely linked external environment, which is predictable to an extent.
Is also known as closely linked external environment, which is predictable to an extent. Clear, guys? I think we have already read that all those parts, right? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Point number three again.
Every business must ensure that it should interact with its microenvironment on daily or regular basis. Otherwise, business will be ineffective and inefficient.
Clear, everyone? If we do not interact with our environment on daily basis, you all know. If we do not actively participate with our environment on daily basis, whether our business will be faded away or not. Do
Yes,
you
sir.
all agree? Write CC if you all understood up to this point. Everyone, please write CC if you all understood up to this point. Okay. So in the micro environment, there are so many elements called cosmic. In the cosmic, what is the first C?
Customer.
Okay, I will ask you a very simple point. If you remember, I gave you the understanding also whether customer and consumer both are same terms or they both are different terms.
Different.
They are different terms. Who is called a consumer? A consumer is the one who buys the goods only for which consumption?
Self-consumption.
Whereas the customer is the one who may buy the goods for the self-consumption as well as for the which purpose? Resale purpose.
Resale.
Clear, everyone? So he may buy the goods for the self-consumption or resale purpose. So every consumer is a customer. Every consumer is a customer. But every customer need not be a
consumer.
I think we have understood all those things. Yes.
Yes, sir.
And he is the ultimate king of the business. He holds the central position. And whenever we are working in a business, what are the things we need to do? We always have to ensure that we should understand the which power?
Bargaining power
of the customer, taste and preferences of the customers, income levels of the customer, benefits, what the customer is looking for, and buying pattern of the customer. So let me ask you a very simple question so that I will understand whether you understood on that day or not. Tell me one thing, guys. When you will like to buy the clothes more, when the fresh stock arrives or when the discounts are going on in the malls?
And discounts are going on.
Okay. And tell me, when the discounts come? During the on season or off season?
Off season.
Off season. So in the summers, winter clothes will be having the discounts or not?
Yes.
Yes. And in the winters, summer clothes will be having a discount. Correct, everyone?
Yes, sir.
So this is what do you mean by which pattern? This is what do you mean by?
Buying pattern.
Buying pattern, right? Now, I think that was the last topic we did on that day.
Yes, sir.
Right? So let us understand the O now. What does the O stand for?
Organization.
Now, everyone, just listen to me carefully. After that, you can read it, right? Harshini, now listen, everyone. Okay.
Yes, sir.
In the organization, there are three categories of the persons in the organization. How many categories? Three categories. One are known as owners. One are known as board of directors. And one are known as employees. An organization can run with them or without them. Without them, organization can run or cannot run?
Cannot run.
Achha, tell me one thing. What do you mean by owners? When it comes to the company, owners means shareholders or not?
Yes, sir.
Now tell me, how a company can make its shareholders happy? By giving them the dividend?
Yes.
Am I correct? Okay. Who are the second category of the persons?
Board of directors.
How the board of directors will be happy if we'll give them the power of the management? Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Who is the third category of the person?
Employees.
How do we make our employees happy and motivated always? If we'll give them the salaries and wages, but along with the salaries and wages, do they expect extraordinary employment benefits like PF, gratuity, ESI, sweat equity shares, ESOPs? Yes or no? Everybody?
Yes, sir.
So suppose Harshini, you are my employee. I'm giving you salary on time, but salary every employee gets. But if I'll give you the gratuity, if I'll give you the PF, if I'll give you the bonus, if I'll give you the sweat equity shares in my company, will you be more happier in doing the work or not?
Yes, sir.
Remember one thing, in the organization, there are three main pillars. Tell me, who are the three main pillars? Owners,
board of directors,
and employees. Do we have to make everyone happy or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Achha, tell me one thing. Who is the biggest enemy of a company? Who is the biggest enemy of a business? Is it one competitor which is sitting outside, or is it the employee who is sitting inside? Think logically. Sir, employee or persons working in the organizations are the biggest enemies of the organization. Now ask me why. It's a very simple thing. If we'll keep them happy, are they going to put their heart and soul in doing the If we'll keep them happy, are they going to put their heart and soul to do the business or not?
Yes.
But remember one thing. If the employee goes unhappy at the end of the day, remember one thing. You are not doing a good business. Kyunki, remember one thing. Employee is the one who is working with the organization throughout the day. He's the one who knows the sensitive information of the company. He's the one who knows the confidential information of the company. Would you like a chance where your sensitive and confidential information will be leaked outside? That is good for the business or bad for the business?
Bad for the business.
But don't you think that we have to keep our employees happy or not? Yes. Remember one thing, if you keep your employees happy, then only you are doing a successful business. I hope everyone is CC up to this point. Clear, everybody? Sorry. Okay. So now read it out from the beginning so that everyone can understand. Read out. Organization.
Organization. Those individuals or persons who are running the business of company in different capacities.
Who are the different capacity people?
Owner, board of directors and employees.
Who are called the owners? Shareholders. Called the owners in case of company and
partners
and sole proprietor. If it's a partnership firm, partners are the owners. If it's a sole proprietorship, sole proprietor is the owner. And if it's a company, who is the owner?
Shareholder.
Who are known as board of directors? Who do what?
Day-to-day decisions of the management.
Who are known as KMPs, guys? Key
manager. Managerial personnel.
Next one.
Manager and directors.
Are they also handling the management of the company or not?
Yes.
Yes. HR. Who is the third person?
Employees.
Now read it carefully. Who actually? Who
do work in an organization and interact with production activity.
Interact with the which activities? Production activity. But ensure that their values and their vision should be in line with the business vision. Now tell me one thing, everyone just look at me now. Suppose the business is going in this direction and the employees of the company are going in this direction. Is it the same direction or opposite direction?
Opposite.
Now tell me, who will suffer?
Organization
will suffer. Are you understanding the point? But if the employees are going in this direction and organization goals are also in this direction, is it the same direction or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, then who will gain? Organization. So always remember your one thing. Ki employees should always work in that direction, in the same direction where the organization is working. If the employee's vision is different and organization's vision is different, in that case, what will happen? Who will suffer?
Organization.
So who will be your biggest employee in that case? Your employees will be your biggest, enemy.
Enemy.
In that case, correct? So tell me, who is the biggest enemy? Is it the outsider competitors or is it the employees?
Employees.
Employees. Now tell me, look at this picture. Is the employee happy or not happy? Look at this picture.
Happy.
He is not happy. If the employee is not happy, tell me what will happen to the organization? Organization will survive or organization suffers?
Suffers.
Now the same thing Mr. Pogo has also said. Same thing Mr. Pogo has said. Now tell me what Mr. Pogo said.
We
met our enemy today. Repeat.
We met our enemy today.
And
he is us.
He is us. Anybody can explain what is the meaning of this line? We met our enemies today. We met our enemies today and he is us. It means we don't have to go outside to look at our enemies. Our enemy is inside us. So who is inside the organization?
Employees.
So remember one thing. Employees are the enemies. Sirisha, do you have any problem? Sirisha, you raise the hand. Should I unmute you? Do you want to participate in the class? Sirisha. Do you want me to unmute you? Okay. Mistakenly raising the hand. Okay. So everyone understood the meaning of the line of Mr. Pogo or not? Right, CC, if you all understood. So today we met our biggest enemy. And who was our biggest enemy? He is what? Us. And us means what?
Employees.
Clear, everyone? Super clear, everyone? So in the cosmic, we are done with C. We are done with O. What is the next thing?
Supplier.
Okay. Now, remember everything. One, I will ask you some few questions. You have to give me the logical answer, including you also, Harshini. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Do you remember our airline industry example, which I told you while doing the Michael E. Porter's Five Forces of Competitive Analysis?
Yes, sir.
Okay, tell me one thing. Is a supplier also an important part and parcel of micro environment or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, acha. If there are a lot of suppliers in the market, what will be their bargaining power in the market? There are a lot of suppliers in the market. Their bargaining power will be higher or less?
Less.
It will be less. And if there are very limited suppliers in the market, what will happen to their bargaining power?
More.
Will be more. Acha, tell me one thing. Okay, one more question. Question is whether the bargaining power of the supplier also affects the business decisions or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes. In our airline industry, whether the number of suppliers were so many or limited?
Limited.
That is the reason our bargaining, their bargaining power was higher in our case or not. And that was an unfavorable force to us. Clear, everyone? Right. Now listen to this very carefully. Suppose I am Ranbaxy company. Do you all know Ranbaxy company?
No, sir.
Ranbaxy Laboratories is nothing but pharma company which manufactures the medicine. Yes, Chetan, correct. It's a pharma company. Now listen. Suppose Harshini is the supplier and I am the Ranbaxy company. Okay? Now, as a Ranbaxy company, do I have to make a COVID-19 medicine? Yes, I have to make a COVID-19 medicine. Now, I have two options. Harshini is already a very big research and development company. Harshini, you are a very big research and development company. You are an R&D company. Are you getting the point?
Yes,
and
sir.
I have two options. As a Ranbaxy, I have two options. Option number one, Harshini is very expensive to be hired. Harshini, your company is very expensive to be hired. Now, should I develop the R&D department in my own company now? Tell me one. Everyone, please give me the answer. If the Harshini as a supplier outside in the market is very expensive, do I have to develop the R&D department in my own Ranbaxy company or not?
Yes.
And if the Harshini, you are very cheaper in the market, means what? Your services are very much cheaper in the market. Now, should I develop the in-house research or should I outsource my R&D to the Harshini?
Outsource.
So tell me, if the supplier is expensive, what should be the decision of the business? In-house or outsource?
In-house.
And if the supplier is cheaper, then in that case?
Outsource.
That is what is written in this particular topic. I hope everyone crystal clear. Everyone understood which I'm trying to tell. So remember one thing, supplier also plays a very, very, very important role when we do the business. Now read.
Supplier supplies raw material, equipments, job work or work in progress work. Company is largely dependent upon its supplier.
Do you all agree company is dependent upon its supplier or not? Yes. Next.
Business always must consider the bargaining power of its suppliers.
And what is the rule?
Limited supplier, higher the bargaining power. More suppliers, lower the bargaining power.
You all agree with this conclusion or not? If there are limited suppliers, their bargaining power will be higher. If there are more suppliers, their bargaining power will be lower. Right, CC, if you all agree up to this point? Okay, clear. Okay, next point. What I told you, read this part. If the supplier is...
When supplier is expensive in-house, if supplier is cheaper, outsourcing.
Now, did I tell you this point also or not? If the supplier is cheaper outside, I should go for outsourcing. If the supplier is very much expensive outside, it's better I should open my own in-house research and development. Clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Clear, everyone? Right? Okay. Chalo, great. Now, in the cosmic, what are the points we are done with? C-O-S. What are the three we are left with?
M-I-C.
Now, in the M, M stands for what?
Market.
Now, everyone listen to me very carefully. Within 2 minutes, the whole M also will be going inside you. Okay. First of all, tell me, are you able to understand me properly?
Yes, sir.
Is my communication better to all of you? Are you understanding the concept? Okay, great. Now, tell me one thing, everyone. There is a customer and there is a market. Customer is a part of market or market is a part of customer?
Customer is part of the market.
Customer is a part of market. Are you getting the point or not? Market includes what?
Customer.
Clear, everyone? So which one is a broader term?
Market.
Market is a broader term and customer is a narrow term. Are you getting the point? So what is this? If customer is this, market is huge. Now tell me, which circle is looking bigger?
Market.
Market. And customer circle is bigger or smaller?
Smaller.
So therefore, market includes what?
Customer.
Clear, everyone? So customer is just a part of a market. Now read, what is market?
Market is a wider term as compared to customer.
Clear, everyone? Next one.
It is a place where buyer and seller comes in contact with each other.
Okay, everyone listen to me carefully. Do you all go to the DMart or any supermarket to buy your groceries for the house or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So what is grocery? Grocery is inside your house or it is in market?
Market.
Who is a DMart? Buyer or seller?
Seller.
And you are what?
Buyer.
So DMart is a place where the buyer and seller are meeting or not?
Yes, sir.
So tell me, what is market? Read the point number two.
It is a place where buyer and seller comes in contact with each other.
Everyone agrees to what I said? Everyone agrees to what I said? Right in the chat box? Yes? Okay, great. Next one.
In case of market, business must consider the following.
Now tell me, did we consider so many things when we talked about the customer or not? His income level, his bargaining power, his benefits, his dislikes and buying pattern. Did we understood so many things when we talked about the customer or not?
Yes, sir.
The same way, so many things we have to consider when we talk about whom?
Market.
Right or not? Now, out of so many things, what is the point number one?
Current trends and potential trends of market.
Everyone, please understand and give me the answer. Should we know the trends of the market or not? Should our business should go as per the trends of the market or opposite to the trends of the market? Tell me.
We have to go along with the trend of the market.
We have to go along with the trend of market. Now tell me, what is the trend now for the CA classes? Is it the face-to-face or online?
Online.
Now I am doing a business of giving the CA classes. So am I giving face-to-face right now, which is not possible, or I am giving the online class?
Online classes. But
did I use my technology in such a way today we are looking like having a face-to-face class or not? Everyone, please tell me.
Yes, sir.
Is it looking like face-to-face class? It is just that you are sitting at your house. I am sitting at my house. You don't feel like. See, blackboard is there in front of you. Instead of whiteboard, it is blue board in front of you. And instead of teacher sitting in front of you, I am sitting at my home. But am I addressing you on live basis or not?
Yes, sir.
So should we know the present demands of the market and the future demands of the market? Now tell me, what is the future of classes? What is the future of classes? Is it the face-to-face or online now?
Online.
Online. Now remember one thing, there are still very huge population in the market which goes for the face-to-face classes. But if we use this kind of technology, tell me one thing, is your time of traveling is getting saved?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Are you comfortable being at your home? Now, let me tell you one thing. Frankly, let me tell you one thing. I am in my comfortable clothes right now. But when I go to take a class, then I have to put some formal clothes. Now, well, yes, very well said. Ismail is saying, hostel expenditures are also getting saved or not?
Yes, sir.
You are able to see your mother and father and having which food? A dirt
food.
Hostel food or a home food? So tell me, do you have the advantage of taking the classes at home or not? Yes. So this is what do you mean by markets, which trends? Current trends.
Potential trends.
Achha, second thing in the market we have to see what?
Cost structure.
Tell me one thing. When the cost increases of a product, what will happen to its selling price? When the cost increases, what happens to the selling price? Selling price also increases. So should we understand? Now tell me one thing. In the Shrestha, are you all able to get the classes? Are you all able to get the classes at a cheaper rate or not?
Yes, sir.
The same way. Now, in my academy also, I'm offering the classes at 12,000, 14,000 bid full group. But if it could have been the face-to-face classes, do we have to pay the rent of a building? Yes. Do we have to print the material? Yes. Do we have to maintain the air conditioner, lightning, electricity bill or not? So that's the reason we also increased from 12,000 to 20,000 when it was face-to-face classes. But now in the online classes, only a good infrastructure and an internet connection is required. Do I have to give you the physical material or PDF files?
Soft copies,
right or not? So my cost of rent is saved, my cost of everything is saved. Now tell me whether my cost increased or decreased?
Decreased.
What happened to the selling price of the classes?
Decreased.
Instead of 20,000, all of you are able to get it at 12,000? The same quality, everything same or not?
Yes.
Right? Okay, next point.
Boom and recession.
Now tell me one thing. What do you understand by boom? What do you mean by recession? First of all, when the market is profitable in nature, that is called what?
Boom.
And when the market is loss making, that is called what?
Recession.
Right now, tell me which market is boom, online or physical?
Online.
And which market is having a recession?
Physical.
So we should also know the boom and recession of the market. Next one.
Price sensitivity of the customer.
Listen to this very carefully. I will ask you two questions to Harshini. You have to give me the answer so that everyone just listen to the Harshini carefully. Okay. Now Harshini, okay. Ready? Okay. Now Harshini, you are from a very middle income level group and you have now started your job. You have that 10 lakh rupees of budget to buy a car. Okay. You went to the Honda showroom and you selected a Honda City car. Now, 1 week back when you went to the Honda showroom, they said that, madam, price of the car is 10 lakhs. How much price they said?
10 lakh.
Okay, you took a week time to make up your mind. Is it correct? Yes.
Sir.
So after 1 week when you went over there, they said that now, madam, the price of the car is 10,70,000. Now tell me, how much increase take place?
70,000.
Now tell me, does 70,000 matters to you?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So are you a price sensitive? Or you are a price insensitive customer?
Sensitive.
Okay. Now you imagine the second example. You are highly rich. Jubilee Hill fellow or Banjara Hill fellow. I don't know whether you know the Jubilee Hills or Banjara Hills or not. But I think in the previous class I told you it's a very rich. Okay. So you are a resident of Jubilee Hills. You went to the BMW showroom to buy a car of 60 lakhs. After 1 week, the seller is saying, sir, now the car is 65 lakhs. Does it bother you?
No, sir.
No. What is the difference?
Not sensitive.
Yeah. What is the difference? 5 lakhs. Are you getting the point? Being a middle class, 70,000 bothered you. But being a very upper class, 5 lakhs bothered you or didn't bother?
Didn't bother.
So you are a price sensitive customer or price insensitive customer?
Price insensitive.
So did you understand the point? We always have to understand the price sensitivity of the customer. Then only we can understand the market. Right? CC, if you all understood with the example. Everyone write CC. Waiting for your CC. If you all understood the example. Clear everyone? Chalo. Move to the next one.
Growth rate of market.
Now tell me one thing. When we enter into the business, should we check the growth rate of the market or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. When I took a decision to enter into which business?
Online business.
Airline business. Okay. Now whether the growth rate in the airline is higher nowadays or very lower?
Higher.
Airplanes, it is very lower right now. Now people are able to travel via air or airline is completely shut down?
Shut down.
Now today's the growth rate of the airline industry is very less. So I also have to consider the growth rate of the market. Clear everyone?
Yes,
right,
sir.
If you all understood? Yes. Okay, what is the next one?
Technology structure.
Now do we all have to adopt the technology according to the changes in the environment?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay, what is the next one?
Distribution system.
Okay, tell me, 90% of the cars in India are BMW Mercedes or Maruti Honda Hyundai?
Maruti Honda.
What is the reason? India is a full of rich people.
Yes, sir.
Can you control that voice, please?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Now see. India is a country of very rich people or country of middle level income people? Most of
middle
the people.
Level income.
So that's the reason Maruti showroom is there in every corner of the city or not? If you
yes, sir.
Now there are 30 showrooms of Maruti in the whole Hyderabad, but there is only one showroom of Mercedes in the whole Hyderabad. Do you all agree? Do you all agree? So whose distribution channel is more in Hyderabad?
Maruti.
Maruti. Why not Mercedes? Because everyone can buy the Mercedes, or out of 100, one person can buy the Mercedes?
Only one out of 100.
So for that one person, should we open 10 showrooms, or only one showroom is enough?
Only one.
But
one
the remaining 99 people can afford Maruti. So do we have to open one showroom or multiple showrooms?
Multiple.
So distribution system of the market is also very important. I hope everyone is getting the idea which I'm trying to tell.
Yes, sir. Right?
And what is the last and the most important point?
Maturity of market.
Everyone, including Harshini, all the girls are going to give me the answer. I'm going to ask you a very frank question. Tell me one thing. If you're wearing the Western clothes and you are going into a temple, whether you and your parents will allow you to go to a temple wearing the Western clothes?
No, sir.
No. But if you're wearing the traditional clothes, they will be more happier or not?
Yes, sir.
You yourself also doesn't feel good when you go to the temple with wearing the Western clothes. Clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
But in the US, do they go to the church by wearing the Western clothes or not?
Yes, sir.
So whose economy is more mature? Whose market is more mature? US.
Yes.
US people are more mature because those are Western countries. For them, you are just a human being. But in India, the thinking process of the people are a little bit different. Still, we have not accepted some of the truths of the life which we should accept. That is the reason India is still a developed nation or developing nation?
Developing nation.
So that is the reason. Market maturity is also very much required. Whether the market today is ready to accept. Now tell me one thing. Can you bring the culture of Goa in Hyderabad?
No.
No. Can you bring the culture of Goa in Hyderabad? No. The reason is very simple. In Hyderabad, there is a Muslim community, Sikh community, Hindu community. All are Hindu people or Muslim people put together. They are staying in Hyderabad. But in Goa, Indians are more or foreigners are more?
Foreigners are more.
So if you want to open a Western clothes shop, which is the best place? Hyderabad or Goa?
Goa.
So market maturity is also very much required to be understood. I hope everyone is CC. Crystal, yes, clear with all the examples. Clear? I think I teach good, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, with the practical example, the whole strategic management goes inside your head? Yes.
Yes, sir.
What is the next element in the I? I stands for what?
Intermediaries.
Now, I will give you one practical example and you will all understand. Sir, we didn't understand this topic in this way. Achha, tell me guys, do you all know DMart? Yes. Okay. Now, Harshini, your mother wants to make a biryani today. Okay. So, yes, she needs India Gate basmati rice. She needs India Gate basmati rice. Biryani rice. She wants a biryani rice. Correct, everyone? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now, India Gate basmati biryani rice is getting manufactured in Haryana. Now, tell me, will your mother or parents will go to Haryana to buy the basmati rice?
No, sir.
No. Is it available at DMart?
Yes, sir.
Now, do you know the manufacturer of India Basmati rice?
No.
No, you don't know. Now, your mother will go to the DMart and she will buy the 2 kgs of Basmati rice, India Basmati rice from there or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, India Basmati rice is there at your home. You are able to make a biryani. You all are enjoying the biryani. With the help of what? Because of what? Because of?
DMart.
Because of what? DMart. So tell me, what is DMart? DMart is an intermediary. DMart is an intermediary where the customer and manufacturer come close to each other. Correct, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Right or not? Without DMart, was it possible for your mother to buy the biryani basmati rice?
No, sir.
So intermediary is also important today to do the business or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now you want to buy an iPhone, but do we have a dedicated Apple showroom in Hyderabad? No. There's no Apple showroom, but do we have Aptronics or Bajaj Electronics or not?
Yes.
Yes. Can you buy the iPhone from the Bajaj Electronics?
No.
Yes. Yes. You can buy an iPhone at Bajaj Electronics or not? Yes.
Okay.
But do we have an Apple dedicated showroom of Apple in Hyderabad?
No.
No. So tell me one thing, what is Bajaj Electronics? Is it an intermediary or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Whose phone you want to buy? Apple. Apple is in US. Am I correct? You are in India, Hyderabad. So it means Bajaj Electronics is nothing but the mediator between the US manufacturer and the Indian buyer or not?
Yes, sir.
So tell me one thing, intermediaries are required or not required in the market?
Required.
Required. I hope every one of you understood the example which I'm trying to tell.
Yes, sir.
Clear, everyone? Right, CC, yes, if you all understood. Okay, great. So tell me, the only disadvantage of intermediary is due to the commission of intermediaries, the price will go a little bit higher. Do you all agree?
Yes, sir.
But at least you are ready to pay the higher price if you get the product on time. Clear, everyone? Sure.
Yes, sir.
Great. Chalo, read the point.
Intermediaries are the one who brings contract or contact in existence between the buyer and seller.
Correct, everyone. Do you all agree? It brings the contract and contact in existence between buyer and seller. Correct, everyone? Agree?
Yes,
sir. Yes. Next point. DMart wala example. Same DMart wala example I told you. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Tell me. Read from here. Is it a considerable force?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Next point.
Considerable force or influence in the business.
Okay. Next point.
Sometimes customers don't know about the manufacturer. It is the intermediaries who bring customer closer to manufacturer.
Now, is it the intermediary who brings the customer closer to the manufacturer or not?
Yes, sir.
So do we need intermediaries also in the market? Yes, we need. But what is the only problem with the intermediaries?
Cost problem.
More intermediaries means what?
More price.
More and more agents will be there, more and more price. That is the only disadvantage. But the disadvantage is very small as compared to the big advantage. Right, CC, if you all understood, in the cosmic I also. So yes, in the cosmic C we are done with, O we are done with, S we are done with, M we are done with, I we are done with. What is the last C?
Competitors.
Okay, now how I will make you learn competitors. Now listen to this very, very, very carefully. Do you all remember Michael E. Porter's 5 forces of competitive analysis?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Out of bargaining power of supplier and other than bargaining power of buyer, what are the 3 other forces we talked about?
Threat of rivals.
Threat of substitutes. Threat of substitutes. Third.
Threat of competitors.
Threat of new entrants. Are you getting the point? Now, let me ask you a very simple thing. Whether it is rival or whether it is new entrants or whether it is substitutes, are they all your competitors or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Think logically. Brooke Bond tea and Tata tea. They are what?
Substitutes.
Yes,
sir.
Brooke Bond tea and Tata tea. They are what? Rivals. Because they are both manufacturing tea only. Clear,
yes,
everyone?
Sir.
Okay. Tata Tea and Nescafe.
Substitutes.
Yes, they are substitutes. Why they are substitutes? One is manufacturing tea and one is manufacturing what?
Coffee.
So tell me, where the same products are manufactured, they are known as what?
Rivals.
Where the similar products are manufactured, they are known as what?
Substitutes.
Remember, same products manufacturer are your rivals and similar product manufacturers are your what?
Substitutes.
Now, Tata Tea is also there in the market. Brooke Bond Tea is also there in the market. Rohit Grover Tea came in the market. Who am I?
New entrant.
Correct or not? Now, when I entered into the market, what I did is I gave 50% off on the day one. Point number one. I did the online delivery. I will do the home delivery and I will make sure that you are getting the best quality natural tea at 50% rate. Now tell me, am I giving the competitors to everyone or not?
Yes, sir.
Clear, everyone? Did you get the point? So competition can be of 3 different types. Now tell me, Harshini, what are the 3 different types of competition?
Threat of rivals.
Substitutes.
Threat of new entrants.
Now, are you able to see all the 3 threats?
Yes,
correct,
sir.
Everyone? Everyone able to see the 3 threats? So tell me, what is the first threat?
rivals.
So under the rivals, what kind of threat you have?
Those who produces same products of and services.
And what kind of threat you can have from them?
Better pricing,
less cost, less better quality, and what?
Low maintenance.
Low maintenance. Clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. Just wait, wait, guys. Give me 1 minute.
Yes.
Okay, everyone, let's come back. Okay, so are you able to see the three types of competition? Are you able to see the three types of competition? We have the competition from rivals, we have the competition from new entrants, and we have the competition from substitutes. Clear? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Clear, everyone? Chalo.
Yes, sir.
Now, next one. Read this point.
Which one, sir?
This one.
Careful analysis of competition.
Careful analysis of competition is what?
Backbone of every business.
Now tell me one thing. Should we take our competitors light or we should carefully analyze our competitors?
Carefully analyze.
If we will not carefully analyze our competition, we will success in our business or we will fail?
Fail.
And we will be unable to grab what?
Opportunities and threats.
We will be surrounded by what? Threats. We will be unable to grab opportunities and we will be surrounded by what?
Threats.
Clear, everyone? Achha, tell me one thing. Tell me one thing. If I do not look at my competitor, let me give you a very frank idea. Now, do you all know that SM was started by Bhanu Chandra sir or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So, is he my competitor?
Yes, sir.
Yes, he is my competitor. Now, tell me one thing. Did I analyze Bhanu Chandra sir very perfectly before coming into Shrestha? Yes.
Yes, sir.
I know that how he teaches because we had a very good relationship. He is a very good friend of mine. Right or not? But I know that ki there are some points where the students start feeling ki they are not satisfied with the content what he is teaching. Am I correct or not? I know that fact. And that is a very bare fact. Now tell me, if I know his weakness, and if his weakness will become my strength, now tell me, whether all the population which are taking the class from him, will I be able to grab the total population or not?
Yes, sir.
So, will I be able to grab the opportunity if I analyze my competitor very well?
Yes, sir.
But Bhanu sir did not analyze me properly. Bhanu sir did not know that I can use this technology by which we can come face to face with each other. Bhanu sir did not realize the fact that you have to give the real time examples. Are you getting the point? Now tell me, yes. Did he lose the opportunity or grabbed by the threats?
He lost the opportunities.
Yeah, he and lost the opportunities surrounded by the threats. So who is the biggest threat to him now?
Me. Competitor.
Are you getting the point? To
yes.
Him, the biggest threat is me. So until and unless in the market, no one comes better teacher than me, till that time I can rule the market. But that is not a fact. No one is a king for the market throughout the life. There will be some time, like after few years or after few months, or you never know. There will be some times who will teach better than me. Then in that case, slowly, slowly, I will be faded out in the market. Are you getting the point or not? So it's a cycle. It's a cycle. I also came into the market by making my other competitors faded away. You all might have heard of one person called Kiran Parsa, sir. Anybody knows Kiran Parsa, sir? Kiran Parsa from Hyderabad. Nobody knows? So Kiran Parsa, sir, why nobody knows? Because right now I am at his place. So Kiran Parsa, sir, used to rule the whole Hyderabad. You know, 300, 400 students used to come to Kiran Parsa, sir, in auditing subject. I first started teaching auditing only. Then I started teaching law and SM. I started teaching 1 year back, frankly speaking. I started teaching SM when 1 year back only. It is approximately my fifth or sixth batch, not more than that. When I was started teaching the auditing, I was having 2-3 students in my first batch, and Kiran sir was having 300 students in the first batch. When I started teaching first time, I'm talking about 2015. Okay. What happened by 2019, situation came vice versa. Are you understanding? Situation is vice versa. Now Kiran sir is faded away from the market. Are you getting the reason? He thought that his competitors are youngsters and they cannot perform better than that. Now tell me, that was an overconfidence or that was an underconfidence?
Overconfidence.
Overconfidence. You should never ever allow your competitors to be lighter. Never think that your competitor is light. Today also, I can guarantee you, if Bhanu Chandra sir will improve little bit of his drawbacks, he can become the best teacher than me. I can guarantee you. Because he's my friend. I know his dedication. I know everything about the Bhanu Chandra sir. Only there are some few areas where he is not good. If he will improvise that, whether he can surpass me or not. Yes, yes, he can surpass me. So remember one thing, analyzing your competitor is the best thing you can do to win over your competitors. If you will analyze properly, it means your backbone will be strong and you will be able to grab the opportunities and you will be able to what? Surrounded. Otherwise, you will be able to get surrounded by whom? Threats. Clear everyone? Clear everyone? So that is why always remember 5 things when you talk about your competitors. How many things?
5 things.
Now read the point number 1. Who
are your competitors?
Who are my competitors? Now tell me, who are my competitors? Praveen Jain sir is my competitor. Bhanu Chandra sir is my competitor. The person to whom I know right now. They are my competitor. Okay. Next one.
What are their strengths?
Now, should I know the strengths of my competitors? Yes. What is the next one?
Their weaknesses.
Should I know the weaknesses also? Yes. What is the next one?
What are their likely monies in future?
Should I also analyze in future what they are going to come up with? Then only I'll be step ahead or not. Now tell me one thing. Are you going to check out an eye on your competitor so that you can defeat them or not?
Yes, sir.
So you should always know what are the likely moves of your competitors in what?
In future.
Right. What is the next one?
Are your competitors aggressive or defensive?
So I have to check, is my competitor aggressive or defensive? So remember one thing, these are the 5 things we always have to keep it in mind, which is known as analysis of competitors. So tell me you guys, what are the 5 things? Point number 1, who is my competitor? What are his strengths? What are his weaknesses? What are his likely moves in future? And what is the nature of my competitor? Is he aggressive competitor or is he a defensive competitor? I hope everyone is CC up to this point.
Yes, sir.
Right, CC. If you understood the way of explanation, if you understood the concept of competitor. So I think we are all done with the micro environment, right or not? So in the micro, yes, are we done with cosmic today?
Yes, sir.
We are done with the cosmic today. Clear everyone? Okay. Now, there is one extra thing which you need to learn. Actually, this is not there in your portion. This particular topic, which I'm going to tell you, is not there in your portion, but I will still suggest you should do that. Should I teach you? It will not take more than 15 minutes. So today, there are 3 topics which I have to tell you. And out of 3 topics, all 3 are not there in your portion. But let me tell you one thing. In ICA examination, even for the new syllabus, this question has been asked again and again. But I don't know why ICA is doing that. But if these questions have a chance of coming into the examination, should I have a right to teach you all these topics or not? Yes.
Yes, sir.
On my face value, you all agreed to learn this business environment chapter, even though this chapter is not there in your portion. But without learning this chapter, the future chapters will be easy or difficult?
Difficult.
Difficult. So that's the reason we are doing something which we are not there in the portion. Now see, what is the topic name, Harshini? Read.
Cooperation in competitive environment.
Remember one thing. Sometimes the competitors have to come and join the hands together to take the maximum use of the market. Is it correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Now, when the 2 people come and join the hands together, that is called what?
Cartel.
That is called cooperation. That is called what? Cooperation. Two people joining the hands together is known as what? Cooperation. Now, here we have to understand three types of business models. How many types of business model?
Three types of business model.
Business model number one is known as what?
Cartel.
Business model number one is known as cartel. Everyone write the spelling of cartel, because the next business model spelling you can't write. Everyone write the cartel. Second one is known as, can you pronounce? It is known as Kairetsu. What is the name of the business?
Kairetsu.
It's a Japanese word. It's a which word?
Japanese
word. So it is a Japanese word. That's why it is named as Kairetsu. So what is the first one we did?
Cartel.
And the second one is?
Kairetsu.
Okay. What is the third one? Third one is known as? Tell me, what is the third one? Conglomerate. What is the third one?
Conglomerate.
Okay, clear everyone? The first one is cartel.
Cartel.
Second one is Kairetsu. And the third one is
Conglomerate.
And they are highly important for your examination purpose. Even if they are not going to come in the examination, but they definitely will come in your MCQ. So we don't want to lose any, we don't want to leave any stone unturned. So even if it is not there in a portion, if there is a still some 1% chance also, we have to cover that. Clear everyone? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now, cartel actually is a very different kind of business model. Let me give you the meaning of cartel. Now, there are three competitors of strategy. Acha, tell me one thing. Do I teach auditing or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Whether Harsha sir also teaches the auditing or not?
Yes. Sir.
Kiran sir also teaches the auditing. Yes or no? Yes. Lokesh CV sir also teaches the auditing. There is one person called Harish Krishnan. He also teaches the auditing. There is one person called Srinath Gupta. He also teaches the auditing. So say for example, there are six faculties of auditing in Hyderabad, right? Yes. Now, when we were having the competition with each other, whether students were getting benefited or not?
Yes.
Okay. Because of the competition, everyone was keeping the price of their classes lower as compared to each other. Right? Who is getting benefited?
Students.
Now, one day we all auditing faculties met at one place and we joined the hands together now. It means all faculties will join the hands together. It means all the six auditing faculties are together or not?
Yes,
so
sir.
When we all will be together, is it called cooperation?
Yes, sir.
Now, can we keep the class price as 12,000 rupees or not?
Yes, sir.
Because in Hyderabad, suppose in the whole India, nobody else teaches the auditing. And those six who taught the auditing, they have joined the hands together. Did we make a cartel?
Yes, sir.
Did we limit the supply?
Yes, sir.
Yes. But demand is higher in the market?
Yes, sir.
What will happen to the price of our product?
Maybe low.
It's going to go up. But tell me, is it fair for the students or unfair for the students?
Fair.
Tell me. Price, you were paying 4,000 for the class. But now we are charging 15,000 rupees for the auditing class. Is it fair for the students or unfair?
Unfair.
So is it a fair cooperation or unfair cooperation?
Unfair.
That is known as cartel. That is known as what? Cartel.
Cartel.
And what is the another name of cartel?
Oligopoly.
And the practical example of cartel is OPEC. Anybody knows OPEC? It is known as oil producer and export countries. What is the full form of OPEC?
Oil producer and
export countries. Now listen to this very carefully. Do you all know Gulf countries or not?
Yes, sir.
Saudi Arabia, Dubai, Kuwait, Oman, Iraq, Iran, all these are known as Gulf countries, right?
Yes, sir.
What these countries are rich of? What these companies, what these countries are having abundant?
Oil.
petrol. Am I correct or not? Now, all these Gulf countries have joined their hands together. Now tell me, the 99% of the petroleum of the world is in the hands of these Gulf countries or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what they will do? They will increase what?
Price.
Now, India is exporter or importer?
Importer.
Now, whether my cost of importing the petrol is also getting higher?
Yes, sir.
Because they are charging higher. Due to that, when I'm selling the petrol to the Indian citizens, what is the cost today? Petrol, 84 rupees per liter. What is the cost today? 84 rupees per liter. Whereas the actual cost, which should not be more than 32 rupees. What should be the actual cost? 32. But how much we are paying?
84.
Now tell me, whether those Gulf countries have made the cartel or not?
Yes, sir.
Is it fair for the world or unfair for the world?
Unfair.
So what is the name of that cartel?
Oligopoly.
OPEC. Yeah. What is the OPEC full form? Oil producers and export countries. We are not in that cartel because India is not an export country. India is which country?
Importing country.
They are the oil producers and they are the export countries. That is why the name of the cartel is known as OPEC. Even though, you know what is the petrol price in Kuwait? Anybody is having an idea?
No, sir.
The price of the petrol in Kuwait is 7 rupees per liter. In their own country, how much is the price?
7 rupees.
And in India?
84.
Now, what is the reason? The reason is they are having abundant of petrol. So that's why petrol price supply is huge. Demand is less, price is less. But in India, supply is less, demand is huge. Therefore, price is also huge. Clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
So out of three corporations, what is the first corporation I told you?
Cartel.
Just before leaving, read it. It is what? Also known as?
Oligopoly.
It is unfair and?
Illegal cooperation.
Now read.
Companies with same business will come and make association to restrict supply and distribution.
Due to which
price increases unnecessarily.
And what is the example?
OPEC.
So remaining Kairetsu and remaining conglomerate will do it tomorrow. Okay, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Chalo, bye everyone. Take care. It was lovely teaching you all. I hope you learned so many topics today. So see you guys tomorrow. And I will share these class notes by today evening in our group, so that every one of you can download. These are the first four chapters. Remaining four chapters, there is another file that I will share when we'll start those four chapters. Clear, everyone?
Okay, sir.
So these are approximately 157 pages of handwritten notes. You can see that all are my handwritten notes only. So that will be given to all of you. Clear, everyone? I hope you are comfortable with the notes.
Yes, sir.
Bye, everybody. See you. Thank you so much for coming to the class. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye, everybody.
Yes, sir.
Bye.
Thank you, sir.